Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy. In the last video, we've learned the basics of using a conveyor in our simulation environment. In this video, we will learn how to reinitialize the position and ask the conveyor to move just a certain distance. Let's get started. Once again, we have our station just the way we left it. Here we have our conveyor, both our conveyors that we need to drive. In the first video, we've learned how to create linear movements or continuous motions for the conveyor. Now let's see how we can reinitialize first the position so that we can start from the right position every time we relaunch the main program. And also let's see how we can create basic incremental motion. So just let's say moving 100 millimeters at a time so that we can bring the next objects or the next model bottle in this case. Okay, so in your station tree, we will remove first our run conv out, and we will remove our run conveyor program here. Okay, so I don't want to use those anymore. I want to use the incremental method for this example here. So that's the first thing. Now the next thing, I will go in init and I will remove my run conveyor out here. Great. Here in our station tree, we have a folder that was there since we begun, called conveyor programs. And in it, you have three subprograms. Those are Python subprograms. One called InitConvPosition, one called NextPartIn, and one called NextPartOut. If you want to know a bit more about Python scripting in general or the Python API, I recommend you to take a look at our documentation. I will have a module on that specific topic later in the training, but for now we'll just touch on the basics and how you can leverage some of the Python scripts that I already created for you. So you don't necessarily need to know how to use them in depth, just need to know how to position them, how to call them, and the slight modifications you can bring here to the table so that it does exactly what you need. So if you have one init conveyor position like this, you right click, you can select edit Python script. It will bring here your init conveyor position.py in VS Codium. If it's not the case, or if you have any issues with running a Python script, you can go to tools options and under Python, make sure that you have the right Python version, and make sure here you have the VS Codium as your Python editor. If I bring back VS Codium, here you will see that the InitConvPosition macro is pretty simple. The only thing we do here is use a simple, so the real deal happens here. So we use a simple command or function called setJoint, and we set the joint value to 0. We do that twice here because we have two conveyors. So if you only had one conveyor, you could get rid of half the code here. So the code would in fact be just 4 lines, including one line to validate that the conveyor you're trying to reach is the right one, one line to set the conveyor position to 0 or whatever value you enter here inside the brackets. You have here sometimes something to define what the mechanism here. So in this case, the mechanism will refer to the string name you entered here. So it's important to have the exact same name here or string you have here in your, I'm going to bring this one here up, exactly the same string as you see here. So conveyor in and conveyor out. If you had another conveyor, you can simply copy and paste that here and just change the name here. So the only two things you have, you really need to change in this Python script is the conveyor name and what is the position you want to initialize it at. So if I come here and I select, I'm going to click here on play. If you do that, you will see that the conveyor will initialize its position. So if I double click on this one, it's now at 0. If I make it 1000, perfect like that, 1000, go back to my script and press play, it goes back to 0. Same goes for the other conveyor. So fairly simple, very useful. I will file save as here, and I will go to my training modules, and I will add that to advanced simulation event, and I will add the initconvposition.py. So now that you have that, the thing that you can do is simply drag and drop that here initconvposition.py to any of your station. You just right click here and edit Python script, and then you can change the values in it, and then you can save it. I would always recommend you to save those as a separated .py file. It can be saved within the RoboDK, the RDK file, but I prefer having those separately. I will explain you why exactly in a video dedicated to Python scripting or API scripting in general. Let's do the same. Let's now take a look at our next part here. So next part in and next part out. If you double click here on next part in, you will see the robot moves, or in fact, the conveyor moves one step forward. If you right click and edit Python script, you will see what's in there. So again, the script is very, very basic. We have one mechanism validation, so it doesn't matter much to make sure that the conveyor name that you've called here exists so that we avoid any crash or unwanted behavior. Then we will go for a move J. So we will move using a move J the mechanism. In this case, the mechanism is the conveyor in. So if you want to affect one conveyor over the other, you just have to change the string here or the name here. And then you have your part travel. How many millimeters do you want the conveyor to move? So in the case of the conveyor in, as I'm moving kind of backward, I need to enter -100. I could have added 100, but if I did so here and Control S, let's say, if I did so and press play, the conveyor would move in the wrong direction. So it's more like a, in this case here, I can tell you like just go for a guess and then switch the sign if you need here. So now that we have -100, we can move in the right direction. So this is how the part in increment works. Just enter the right conveyor name here, just enter the right distance here, and you can then, after you dragged and drop it in your station here, call it at any moment to move the conveyor one step forward. So I'm gonna save that here in your file so that you guys can have access to it. By the way, by default, they are all saved in your temp file. So like I said, this is why I preferred having those saved elsewhere, because the temp file will be kind of overwritten or erased if you restart your computer. Okay, so here, save in, and I'm going to right click here, the next part out, edit this one here. And you can see the only difference here, instead of having conveyor in, I have conveyor out. And here in this case, I need to go to move forward 100 millimeters instead of backward 100 millimeters. So let's go file, save as, and then training module here, simulation event, save here for the conveyor. So now you can have access to those three subroutines. So init conveyor position, next part. Honestly, I could have just gave you next part here and next part in and next part out, and you can just modify those. By the way, you can simply open also VS Codeium and simply drag and drop stuff in it if you want to modify some of those subroutines, and they will be linked to RoboDK still, and you can press here play to make it run. Okay, so let's close that. Let's simply reset our station the same way we had it before we started talking about conveyors. So I just need to go back to my pick and scan, and I just need to re-add my next bottle part in. I want to show you a little issue we have, or hiccup, just so that you don't get caught. If you select here, start thread before you go and you select here, sorry, I need to right click, add instruction, wrong call instruction. I don't need to modify the one. If you select start thread before selecting program, and then you go here and select, I don't know, next part out, and you come back, it will revert back to program call for now. So I will bring that issue up, but just make sure to select the program first and then select insert code here, or in fact, sorry, start thread here. So this way you have the right, the behavior you're looking for. So now if I launch my main program, everything works, should work properly. Conveyor motion, scan, out, conveyor motions, motion here. Okay, so that's everything for this video. I hope you found it helpful. I do like using conveyors in incremental mode like that. I think it's really cool to bring in, to bring forward some parts. I also use the same method if I have part feeders, the ones you saw in the Game Boy assembly, like the screw feeders or the backplate batteries or back panel feeders were created in pretty much the same fashion. So that gives you an idea how you can kind of create animations that were not necessarily intended to be created if you are a bit creative with that kind of small Python macro. In any case, I hope you've liked it, you've enjoyed it. In the next one, we will learn how to modify the color of an object, and that will lead us to the light signal that you saw in the overview, so where we can kind of show the state of the scanning process. So yeah, so that will be the main subject of the next video. Hope to see you there. Have a great day, guys.